Hey guys and girls, welcome to another episode of Farming Simulator 19. In today's episode, guys and girls, what we're going to do today is we are going to check out a new mod that I found on Farming Simulator 19 mods.com. And of course, it's a ram. So what we're going to do is we're going to go check it out. And we're going to see if this ram can do all the things that a farm truck needs to do. So here we go. Got a couple of rams. There it is. At the end there, $54,000. Now, this ram has a couple of interesting options. You can have it as a flatbed. Okay, so you can see here, it's just a flat tray. A lot easier to put pallets and things onto when it's a flat tray. Not so good for logging because things can slide off. Not so good for that sort of aspect. So we're going to put the tub on it, make it into a dually. We're going to make it into a ranch hand, but the fuel tank does actually take up a bit of bedroom. So we're going to see if we can get that without. Beautiful. Now what the ranch hand does is it adds this nice big bull bar. You can see you can get it just with the fuel tank or just with the toolbox. So there's quite a few options. So I like it with the bull bar. Now let's see if we can change the color to something more appropriate. We'll take the red, actually. Let's make that a more scarlet red. Beautiful. That looks good. Now, I'm going to change the desired color on the bottom to silver. Do I want new silver, gunmetal, gray? Might take that silver there. No, actually, let's take the new silver. Beautiful. Okay, now, it comes with a couple of engine options. We start out with a 300 horsepower eco diesel. We move up to a 350 horsepower 6.7 inline 6. And then we move up to the high output version, which boosts our power up to 385. So we're going to grab that one. I love this mod for the fact that you can change the paint job to suit what you like and the nice big chunky bull bar. So let's see. Here it is over here. So, what a farm truck needs to do in order to be successful and allowed on my farm, it has to perform several duties. Now, it has to perform all the duties that the standard lizard pickup can do. So, one of the first things it has to do is it has to be able to pull a trailer. Now, I've got a simple trailer over here with just a skid steer attached to it. Okay, and as you can see, the standard four-door lizard pickup, which you get in the game, did lift its tail up a little bit. So, let's see what happens when we go for a quick drive. We'll go around here. Go up to the farm, turn around, come back. Now it can pull this trailer, no worries at all. Oh, little bit of tail slappiness happening there. But we're getting about 60 kilometers an hour. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Let's do a quick turnaround. Go down here, through here, and back down. So about 60 k's an hour. Okay. So the ram has to do everything that this truck can do. Pull the trailer. Do some mild. I call it mild, but it has to be able to carry logs in the tray. It has to be able to carry at least a pallet and carry two square bales of straw or hay. And we've got some hay here today. So, the standard lizard pickup tows that trailer, no problems whatsoever. Now let's see how it goes when we load it up. So we'll fold the tailgate down and let's go load him up. Now the first thing we're going to load it up with is the bales. So we use a forklift. Now if I had a telehandler, I could probably put things in the tray a little bit better, but I've got a forklift, so we'll just live with that. There's 4,000 litres of hay right there. So we're going to come all the way back. Go all the way forward. and put it into the tray. Now, because this is a dual cab, I don't think they'll quite fit. Nope, a little bit off, but that's all right. As long as it can be secured and we can drive with it, everything will be fine. So right, over we go to the standard lizard. Make sure we put those fastening belts on. Okay, and let's see how we go. Now, it's a little top heavy, just a bit. Once again, we go on our standard road test, which is out to the main road. Around the corner. Oh, a little bit tippy. But as you can see, I could transport this all the way to my farm. No problems whatsoever. And that's what a farm truck needs to be able to do. Needs to be able to carry supplies I need, either to a tractor located out in a field, or it needs to be able to carry some hay or some straw. Now the reason why I use the big square bales on my testing is because it's a lot easier to test whether it can take the weight of two bales when they're square as it is to try and balance two round ones. So the standard lizard pickup passes the second test, no worries whatsoever. Alright, so we stop, we unfasten those belts, we hop out and we unload it. Come back, turn around. Pull those bales out. Lower it to the ground. Yeah, we're a bit of an odd angle, but that's all right. Everything's good. Everything is awesome. Now we pick up our pallet. Now I'm using horse feed as our pallet today. Main reason being is because this is what I quite often transfer to my farm when I have horses. So we go in, we go around. This is just as much a forklift handling course as it is a testing of trucks. Okay, now the problem with a forklift though is you can't quite get the pallets in as far as you would like. Okay, I can pick it up. I can stick it in a little bit further, but not much, because getting it back out is going to be fun. Alright, as long as we can get that secured and strapped in, show will be good. Okay. Take it on our road test. Up to the farm, turn around, come back. Now see, the standard lizard pickup truck can do everything that I need it to do as a farm truck. Okay, it can haul a load on a trailer, it can carry a pallet in the tray, and it can do it a lot quicker than what a tractor can. So these are all the rigorous tests that I throw all my farm trucks through, and if they fail just one of these tests, they do not make it onto my farm. Okay, we hop out and we'll unload that pallet. Where's our forklift? Hello, forklift. There you are. And out we come. Not real secure, but there we go. All done and dusted as far as farm loads are concerned. The final test for the lizard pickup is, can it do logging? So I've got some logs already pre-chopped down over here. So I'm just going to pick one of them up. Just one. I've got four here just in case I accidentally throw one into the stratosphere. Oh, that's the jump button, not the grab button. Okay, we take it down. Stick it in the tray. Now, for it to pass the test, it has to stay in the tray. So if I put it down here, it stays in the tray. It doesn't sink down towards the ground. Okay, so we fold the tray back up. We'll put our tension belts on, and we go for a drive. So as you can see, the lizard pickup passes my farm truck test no problems at all. It can tow, it can do lumber, it can do pallets, it can do hay bales. No worries at all. Now do you see the reason why I put the tailgate up? Because the log is lower than the height of the tub, the tension straps don't exactly hold it together. But if you stack the wood on top, it would hold it securely. Alright, so there we go. The lizard pickup, which is the one you get with the game, passes everything I need a farm truck to do. Alright, let's undo those tension belts and get that log out of there. Alright, now the question is, can the ram do everything that the lizard farm truck can do? So, for this ram, which I found on FarmingSimulator19mods.com, do everything I need a farm truck to do. So let's hop in. Pretty good interior. Nice sunroof, so you can see when people are loading things over your head. Toolbox, ram, center console. Ooh, and a manual. Nice. Even though it still has the hockey puck transmission. Okay, kind of odd, but alright. I can forgive that. So, can it tow? There's 60 k's an hour, so it can pull this trailer just as good as the standard lizard pickup. Alright, it's a little bit bigger, so it does take a little bit more room to turn around, but yep, it can tow just fine. So that's test number one passed. That's looking good for the ram. Handles quite good. As I said, it is a little bit bigger than the lizard, so tolerances for maneuverability are acceptable. Alright, so disconnect. Let's take it over to here. Alright, let's drop that tailgate. And let's see, can we fit two bales of hay slash straw in the back tray? Now, as I said to you guys before, if I had a telehandler, I'd be able to push loads to the front of the tray a little bit better, but we've got the forklift, should be fine. In we go, up we come. Now let's hope I don't drop it. Okay, we come up, level the forks out just a bit, slide it on in. Look at that, that tray is pretty much big enough to not only take the two bales, which we're going to secure, but also fold the tailgate up. So how does it feel when carrying the two bales? Not an issue at all. Look at that, 78, we're probably going to hit our top speed, maybe, nope. Look at that, it can fold the tailgate up and still hold the two bales. That's excellent. So the ram passes test number two, able to carry two bales of straw slash hay in the tray, no problems whatsoever. And the added advantage is it can actually fold the tailgate up, so it's a full length tray. That's kind of cool. Alright, so we'll come down, we'll fold that tailgate down again, we'll undo those fastening belts, and we will unload our ram. So, that's test number two, passed with flying colours. Up and out. Alright, so we'll move on to our next test, which is the pallet. Now, I'm pretty sure if that tray can fit two, full-length bales of straw slash hay, that you could probably fit two pallets of supplies in the back. But because we've only got a forklift, I'm not going to be able to put this all the way to the front. In fact, I'm pretty sure I just messed that up. There we go. Down, and can I slide out? Yep, good. Hop out. Hop in. Fasten the tension belts and off we go. Now, as I said, if I had a telehandler, I could probably push this pallet all the way to the front of the tray and we'd fit two in no problems at all. But as you can see, the ram's handling this just fine. No worries whatsoever. So the ram passes test number three. No problems at all. Able to carry pallets of supplies, whether it be to a cedar in the middle of a paddock, or a pallet of food to either the pigs or the horses. No problems at all. Now, I wonder if it can pass our third and final test to make it as a vehicle on my farm. And that is, can it do lumber? Unfasten those belts. Now, the reason why lumber is so important to me is because when you're first starting out in Farming Simulator 19, you may not have enough cash to buy what you want for your farm straight away. So what you're better off doing is buying yourself, if you start out as a new farmer, keep the existing tractors you've got, then buy yourself a decent farm truck, get yourself a chainsaw, and just cut down whatever trees you see on the properties you own, and then sell the timber. And that'll get you some cash pretty quick. So let's go over, grab ourselves a log. Now, I keep hitting the jump button, I apologize. Run over, let's see if we can stick it in the tray and it stays there. Does it fall through? Nope. Beautiful. Alright, let's hop in, fasten it down. As you can see, the advantage to this ram is the tension belts are nice and low, so I don't even need to fold the tailgate up for that log to stay exactly where I put it. Look at that, it's not moving about the tray, it's not sliding anywhere. So this ram has passed all the tests I have for a farm truck. This will be a welcomed addition to my farm. I love the fact that it's dual tone, so I can paint it in any color combination I'd like. It handles timber, it handles towing, it handles pallets, it handles the hay bales, it does everything that I need a farm truck to do, with the added benefit of being able to fold up the tailgate and still keep all your supplies in the tray. Alrighty. So there you go, guys and girls. This ram has made a welcomed addition to my farm. As you can see, I love the bull bar on it. I think that this would not look out of place on an Aussie farm. That would, no bull bar. This has a nice big bull bar on the front of it, and it would be a welcomed addition on my farm. Alrighty, guys and girls, so you can expect to see this ram in up and coming episodes. It may even make to be the new replacement ram on our legit-ish series. So stay tuned for that. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and get the little bell on so you guys know when I'm going to upload the next episode. But there you have it, guys and girls. This ram will make a nice addition to my farm. Until next time, I will say bye for now.